ado, June.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to my spring talk. So basically, in the beginning of the year, we explore privilege. Privilege is that thing we have that others are not fortunate to have. Each of us in the class had to look deep into ourselves to discover what exactly that was. For me personally, it was education. I had always been privileged enough to have the very best education I could possibly have. However, many of the people from Nigeria are not as privileged as I was. And that right there was the start of my project, exploring Nigerian education. Beginning. Attempting to explore Nigerian education in Nigeria, my project quickly came to a standstill. Mainly because all the contacts that I reached out to did not have either the time or the resources to help me with my questions. And that pretty much spoke to how busy the Nigerian teachers were. But instead, I decided to focus on something more personal to me, which was Nigerian students, because I'm a product of the Nigerian educational system, and I have many friends on campus too who are the exact same. And there were resources available to me on campus that I could easily use and come into contact with. And I personally felt deeply connected to it. And so I took this chance to create a survey that basically inquired into each person's educational background, from how academically engaged they felt to how often they went to the teachers for help. Each question was specifically created to contrast their past education to their current education. And some of the survey questions are up there for you to look at. The first one was, what were the major highlights of your experience in school in Nigeria? What was it like to transition to a new educational system? What were your favorite classes to learn about in Nigeria? How often did you go to see your teachers for help? It's just a few of the questions that I personally used to get a feel of everyone's educational background. And sending out the surveys to Nigerian students for general feedback. The surveys I sent out were returned with honest answers, but after analyzing the responses, I noticed some gaps in them. And each gap came up when it was time to discuss the transitional period between the old schools and Mertensburg. It was interesting because it is human nature to want to gloss over the bad parts of our life, the parts where we feel unconfident, unsure, and just generally where we felt alone and weren't exactly safe on campus. Because we're in a new environment where we didn't know anyone and we found it difficult to adjust. So, and many of them felt this way about the transitional period. However, I was there, I was with a big gap in my information, and I needed to solve this gap because, well, I had to do something for my project, so. It was really important I solved the gap. And the gap was the inability to discuss their period of adjustment. And I knew that a survey would never fully be able to capture how they felt, because this was the type of thing that couldn't really be discussed in words. It was something that couldn't be really written down. I had to discuss it with them face to face to get a real feel of how they adjusted. And I did this in a very subtle way by just inquiring in a conversational manner to just find out how they felt when they first came. And some of the responses are actually above for you to look at them. The first one comes from Florida Deomi. He's a junior campus. He says he felt uncomfortable and out of place. This was a whole new culture for him. There's so much to learn. And luckily, he had a roommate who felt the same way, coming from a different place. And this helped create a bond between them. The second one comes from Rahama Sahib. She says she felt overwhelmed but excited. Mertensburg was not Grange, her old school in Nigeria. It was a complete different experience. And it was all very nerve-wracking. Now, I saw this and I just thought, well, if one set of international students felt this way, then it's very possible that all of them did, like all international students generally. And I actually went to other international students and asked them the exact same things and just find out how they felt as well. And Alexandra Dukova had this to say. She said she was lost. She didn't know where everything was. She was confused, but everyone seemed very nice. And she eventually found her place. And you know what? I thought our early international students, I might as well expand it to the national students as well, just to see how they felt, to get a different perspective of the international students. And Maddie Jones said, she said that it depended on people's personalities. Some people seem well set up by the first day, and others even now still seem out of place. And just looking at all this, I thought there was obviously a problem here. Some people struggle to adjust, and I thought, you know, as my springboard project, what could I personally do to help to shorten this time taking to adjust? And I came up with a solution called the Culture Buddy Program. And the Mercerburg Academy Culture Buddy Program will be a program to help international students make an easy transition and better ease themselves into the Mercerburg community faster. The main idea is to match a current student to a new international student using similar interests and grade level as a key to correspond to each other throughout the summer via email. And eventually, when the students arrive on campus, we would have a formal dinner to introduce themselves to actually get a face-to-face meeting between the students. And so the goal of the program would be to help international students make an easy transition, to create a bond between students, to encourage cultural awareness, and to create lifelong friendship between students. And this was basically the added project of my entire year in Springboard. This is what I came up with. And I'd just like to thank Ms. Dyson, Ms. Howie, and everyone involved in Springboard for allowing me this opportunity to explore something that was really dear to my heart. Thank you very much. Now, any questions?
Jude, if you had a buddy system, would you buddy up an international, maybe you said it, I missed it, an international student with a national student, or anybody who just wanted to volunteer to be a buddy, or how would you look to do that?
Well, we can use anything, to be entirely honest. We can use, if someone's on campus available from the same, has the same nationality as they do, that would be perfect, and we can just match them up. But if that's not available, then we can just pick someone in their grade who has a similar interest as them. For example, if the person incoming really enjoyed soccer, we could find someone on campus that loves soccer too, and they could match them up. Questions? Oh, ask a question.
Yeah, that was good. Yeah.
During our conversations, Jude, before about, you know, some of your ideas, I know this came up in conversation, and we talked maybe about using current student leaders or the idea of tasking prefects or peer group leaders. Have you thought any more about kind of how you would implement it prior to students' arrival on campus, and whether you would use those leaders or if you would just reach out to other students, kind of to piggyback off of Trini's question?
Honestly, it could work either way. Student leaders could volunteer and offer it up behind, and that would make it a lot easier because, like for example, the prefects could just choose to email maybe everyone on their, every new international student on their wing or floor, and just make sure they have someone on campus already when they come to just show them around and have a familiar face. So when you come, you won't feel as alone as you would have if you didn't know anyone. But yeah, student leaders could get involved, or anyone who wants to volunteer. It really is an open program that just anyone within the Mercerburg community could just come out and help to bring other people in.
You talked about how the transition for international students to come to Mercerburg was difficult, especially like, for example, how you came from a British educational system to an American one. Personally, I went to an American school all my life, so I didn't find it that hard to adjust, but can you explain to me the difference between British education and American, and the challenges in this region?
Most of the challenges will actually be cultural changes, to be entirely honest. It's the way things are done in Nigeria, for example. It's not the same way they're done here. And in terms of classes in Nigeria, we take a lot more classes than we take here. We took about 14 classes. And it was, well, those classes were not as challenging as the classes that we take here. So basically, those were some of the things. And I personally did not know that when I was coming. I thought I'd have to take the same, like, 10 classes, and I come here and only have five, and I was I was excited at first. I was like, oh, 5 classes, that's gonna be easy. And then the 5 classes came and, But this was one of the challenges. But focusing more outside the classroom would be cultural changes. Because like in Nigeria, for example, we refer to everyone as an aunt or an uncle. And we don't exactly do the same thing here. Other people, so that's some of the things that we, you know, learn about the culture buddy program. Did I answer your
question? Yeah. Based off your research and everything, what is the difference between teacher-students relationship in Nigeria and like here in Versailles?
Oh, honestly, I feel that even though with the like I mentioned, they call each other like aunt, uncle. Even with that, it's still kind of hard to go talk to your teachers in Nigeria because you they don't exactly seem as open as the teachers do here. And just adjusting to that, for example, like the teachers here seem more open and welcoming and encouraging of questions. And that's just because of how the classroom is set up with smaller groups, so you can actually talk to your teachers more and not feel as if you're being judged.
Actually, I think that's a good point because working with my advisees, many times, even coming from public schools within the U.S., there's a lot of students who aren't used to the teachers being as open and their time availability to for students to ask for help and so forth. So I find that as one of the things that is hard for a number of students to just realize that, hey, they're not a bother. Hey, they can ask questions. Hey, the teachers are here. And I've had advisees that I've had to say, listen, that's what we're here for. Do you know what I mean? So I think that's an issue across the board.
How many students did you interview? And did you, I mean, you shared the quotes that was really good, but did you find, if you did interview a lot of students, and maybe you didn't, but if you did you find, you know, trends that were there that, like, if a culture ready program were developed, that they would know, you know, what to address? Because as Trini said, I know there are things that we think, but I just wondered if you did a lot of interviews, and if you did you find some commonalities that were kind of big themes that might be incorporated into the program?
Some of the research I did, I've mainly focused on Nigerian students at first, and most of the gaps were just like maybe converted from the system they use, like the metric system, for example. Wait,
mm-hmm.
The other way around.
Right.
Like, I was definitely confused for many of them, but some of the culture gaps were like, for example, some mentioned this is like a really, might be a silly one, but some mentioned they didn't figure out the showers until like a while. And that's just something that could be addressed because they were a bit difficult to work with first, from the interviews I gathered. But as to the actual difficulties for each person, I feel like that could be tackled more as the students speak to each other via email. Because students are more willing to talk to other students because, well, you know,
right, but my question was, you know, what would you find? I think if you had culture buddies and there were things that you knew were trends that people needed to address, then in the culture buddy program, those people who volunteered to do it would know even, you know, what to address before the student, you know, 2 weeks in, had to tell them they didn't know how to use the showers. That's a good example. They might, like, incorporate that from the beginning on common things that'll be good for you to know.
Oh, just like general Mercer terminology, like every Marshall Week, that could be put into just to understand the feel of the campus. Plus, RLMs too could be explained, and community gatherings, all this stuff could just be explained. Just to give them, just make them feel like they already have an idea of what's going to happen on campus when they come, instead of just throwing them into the deep end.
Do you plan
to, like, have this be just like a summer thing where you, like, people kind of get in contact with each other before the school year, or do you plan for it to be something where people can stay in contact, like, throughout the school year? Well, the initial contact would be made over the summer via email, but then when they come to campus,
they would have a dinner to introduce themselves. Then throughout the years, activity could be planned to help them grow closer together, like bowling trips or movie trips, just simple things that could help them to help them become better friends, basically. And put them in an environment where they can talk to each other more and have a nice time.
Can you think back to the first week you were here? Is there one thing or a couple things that would have been really helpful for you in the transition? I know you've alluded to some of them, but anything that's on your mind?
The first week I was here was a blur. I really can't remember that well. But one of the things I know was that I was definitely confused where to go. I had no idea what to do. We had soccer practice like on the turf, and I had no idea. That was something that I personally struggled with, just like finding out where everything was.
Maybe a tour of campus or something.
Yeah.
Yeah, what about?
I think what would be good, Jude, is to get a number of those things for incoming students and create a list of things that students really struggled with, and give it to maybe the admissions, maybe Mrs. Rutherford, or so that, you know, we know that when you come to a new place, there's always things to learn. But specifically, coming from a student's point of view, you know, because we do have peer group, we do have the initial week of getting, but that's so overwhelming. That if you came up with a list of just a number of things that you thought were the top 10 things that people struggle with being a new student versus where, I think that would be really helpful.
I think, Ty, isn't that your project?
Mine's like a project of like how it works, so like kind of.
Yeah, so yeah, his project basically tackles that, but I could work with Ty, let's say, you know.
I mean, because I think that would be really helpful. I really do.
Yeah.
Like, who thinks of the showers? Like, who thinks of how to turn on the shower, hot and cold, and the pressure? Like, we don't think of that. You know, so I think that would be really helpful.
The laundry.
I think the one thing that could definitely help you is, like, the roommate, like, serving and intake coming into the school is very broad, and like you said, you need to find stuff that's like connection wise. So I think more like specific questions would definitely help to tackle finding a roommate that would have more like connection to you. Just that suggestion.
Two things. Ms. Crouch and I have talked about this topic a lot, but you know, one thing that we've wondered is, should we have international students come into Mercersburg for a preseason before preseason? So it'd be interesting to hear what you thought of that. And then just a comment, when Derek Gay was here last week and we had a follow-up meeting with him, and he was talking about, you know, identity and how we all identify, and that sometimes schools can focus on international students and think about what they need, but what we ignore, and I thought this was really true, was actually having our students who are from the United States understand what it's like to be an international student, how to talk to students about, like, if they're speaking Korean or German, and, you know, what they should say and do. But sometimes we forget about our students from the United States who, you know, are experiencing everybody's different identities, whether it's international or whatever, you know, really having the whole conversation too. That's just a comment, but I wonder what you think about that kind of preseason idea.
I think it's a great idea, but I feel like it shouldn't be really like mandatory for everyone to take part of it. It should be more of an optional thing, yes. And just see, because some people would really appreciate that, make it easier for them. And if possibly, if they are like, if the people who choose to sign up for it are comfortable and they get to know the campus well enough, like, they can help even the new international students and help them out too. It's kind of like a ripple effect. It just keeps going.